Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and let's play some more Hearthstone for you. I do want to thank everyone who has been watching and liking the series thus far. I do appreciate all the comments that I get. People say they do enjoy my style of commentary when I'm thinking about plays and whatnot, and I will continue to bring you Hearthstone content. Today I'm going to be doing the Mage Daily Quest. As you see here right now, I did get a Mage Victory Daily Quest, so basically I need two games to win as a Mage, which are pretty easy, because let's be honest, Mage is overpowered, am I right? It doesn't matter what game it is, they are always overpowered. So obviously I need to make a Mage deck real quick here. As you see, I do not have a Mage deck, so I'm going to go ahead and create a Jaina deck. There we go. Now, I would like to point out that I do not play a mage as my main. I do play as a warlock. That is my main. So, let's see how this goes. I think I'm going to look for not really a spell power deck, more so a board removal and crowd control deck, I think would be the best thing to do. Mirror image is always nice. I'll grab one of them. I don't want to grab two of them because they're 0-1 and they're actually pretty fragile like that, and they can be dealt with very, very easily. Ice Lance is always very nice. I'm going to grab one of them. Arcane Explosion is always good for removal. I'll grab two of those. I'm not really a huge fan of Frost Nova that much, but I'll probably take one here just in case. Sorcerer Apprentices are excellent if you can get them out there early, so I will grab one of them. I have to go with Arcane Intellect. It's two free cards, basically, in the late game. Cone of Cold is nice because it does indeed do damage, but I need to be a little bit cautious. I already have eight cards here. I'm not a huge fan of playing secrets, but fireballs are nice. Polymorphs are, of course, that you have to have polymorphs, especially if you're going in the higher ranked leagues. Ladder, of course. I'm not really a huge fan, again, of the Aether Arcanists. I'm not a secret player because I think they're kind of lame. I am going to grab one Frostbolt. And that is going to be that. I'll grab one Flame Strike just in case. So as you see, I have about 14 cards. All of them, only one of them is a minion, actually. So I may have to shed a couple of pounds here before I take this deck into battle. I'm going to look for lots of taunts. I'm going to look for lots and lots of damage that I can put out immediately. Let's see here. I do need to get a hold of taunts first. I will take one Frostwolf Grunt. I always have to get the Silencer. Spell Power is very nice. Knife Jugglers are very nice indeed. Loot Hoarders, because they do have a card draw. And again, I'm probably going to fill up here, and then I'm going to go backwards and then see what else I need. I don't really need any more card draw. Again, I'm not really going to be playing a Spell Power deck as much as I just need to remove minions off the board, and that way I can build towards a quick victory. So questing adventurers are nice, but unfortunately it doesn't really look like I have right now any sort of protection that I can give them. I'll grab Ancient Mage. Maybe. I like enrage creatures because I do have the ability as a mage to actually attack them by myself. And I don't have to wait for them to gain an enrage. Defender of Arguses are nice. Let's see here. We do need a lot of the beefy tanks. So we'll grab both of those tanks there. Silences are always very, very nice. I'm a huge fan of the Fen Creepers. Now, I'm starting to kind of not like the Booty Bay Bodyguards too much. They're starting to kind of wane on me a little bit. Let's see. Late game cards here. I'm not really a huge fan of my late game cards. The Ravenhold Assassin is nice as a finisher. I don't know if I'm going to actually use him or not because I am pretty limited in my card real estate. I will grab one Archmage just in case if I do need the late game firepower for spells. Keep in mind, spells do not affect your hero power. They only affect the actual spells in your hand. So keep that in mind. I got one more card left here. And I'm looking for... Do I not have a pint size? I thought I had a pint-sized summoner. Maybe I don't have a pint-sized summoner. I thought I... could have swore I did. Maybe I don't. I may have actually imagined it. Not sure. It wouldn't surprise me if I actually imagined that I had a pint-sized summoner. So let's go ahead and grab the... I'm looking for the... there he is. Alkaline of Pain. And that's the one where if you actually do damage to him, he will draw you a card every time. And again, that's basically a free card draw at that point. So looking over this here, 30 for 30. I'm not really a huge fan of this deck. I have a lot of spells, not a whole lot of minions. I'm going to go ahead and get away a Frost Nova. Ice Lance is okay, but I have no way to actually... I have better ways to use one mana, so I'm going to go ahead and get rid of Frost Lance. Or Ice Lance, I'm sorry. Mirror Image I'll keep out just in case if I need them. If I need to protect a minion on the field, I have to keep Arcane Explosion. Arcane Intellect is it's not optional at this point. So let me see if I can get something a little bit juicier to put in the... Let's see what my arc is looking like. Oh, man, I need a lot of late-game cards. So let's go for two late-game cards here. I'm going to grab one of the Ancient Mages, and then, you know what? Let's go ahead and grab the Cult Master as well. Let's see what we can do with this one. This is probably not going to end well, but who knows? Who knows? I am going to be playing on the unranked ladder. As you see, I did hit Diamond Star 1, whatever that means. Again, ladders don't really matter all that much in Hearthstone, but I'm always as enjoying the series. I'm enjoying the game, rather, and I'm glad that you all have been enjoying the series. I know that I've spent probably a little bit more money than I should have on Hearthstone, but to me, it is worth it. Now, I will say that I am planning on hitting it pretty hard when the game finally does come out. I'm looking forward to the first beta wipe so I can actually start getting cards that I can actually keep. Because for those of you who don't know, the Blizzard is actually doing a card wipe, an account wipe, when the first beta phase is over. Meaning that we can't really keep the cards that we have right now, but we will gain the money that we have gotten back in our account via gold. We're not going to get money back, we get gold back. So, terrible, terrible draw first here. It does look like I do get, I trade a Shield Master for a Warden, and I probably would have preferred to keep the Warden. Knife Juggler, and then Flame Strike as well. Not really a great draw at all, and especially against Shaman. One thing that you do have to remember about Shaman is that they are what I would like to call a minion-dependent class. They rely on flooding the board with as many cheap and quick minions as possible, and then subsequently getting them out there and buffing them to all hell with Bloodlust. And we all know what Murlocs can do with Bloodlust. So it does look like I'm going to get pretty limited with what I can do early on here, but by turn three, I should be able to have a little bit of more options. Totemic Call comes out. There's a Searing Totem. So a pretty nice draw for him. I do finally get the Frostwolf Grunt. However, I don't need to play him right now. I'm going to use him as a retaliatory minion here and just respond to what my Shaman opponent does because he has many different ways to remove anything that I throw on the board right now, especially when I don't have any Taunters out there. And I was not going to sacrifice the Frostwolf Grunt. It can get Lightning Bolted. It can get Frost Shocked by a spell and then subsequently just one-shot by the Searing Totem. So I'm going to make him rebuild that totem, and let's see here. So Mirror Image comes out, and that is a very, very nice card indeed. I am going to go ahead and get the Knife Juggler out, and I will summon the Mirror Images out there. That indeed will allow me to get two shots off with the Knife Juggler. Unfortunately, I did not get enough to kill the Stone Talon totem, or Stone Claw totem, but that is fine by me. And our Knife Juggler does have a little bit of protection out there. Again, it is Mirror Images, so it's not that big of a deal. But as you see there, if played right, you can synergize it with anything you want, like the Knife Juggler. That is why I like him. Searing Totem does indeed come out. And I will be surprised if he doesn't attack right here or throw out another minion. He's got a lot of cards. It's 2, 4, 6. He's got 8 cards in his hands right now. And I'm not really sure. Oh, he's going to go ahead and burn the coin now, so that is fine by me. It's probably going to be it's going to be a raid leader, so he's going to use that to take out the mirror images. Or maybe not. I guess he couldn't. So we're sitting here at 5 mana now. I would really, really like to put 2 units out on the board. However, I can't do that. But let me see what we can do here. So I'm going to go ahead and throw out a Shield Master. And the RNG does indeed get the Stone Claw Totem. I'm fine with that. I'm going to go ahead and... let me see here. I could take the Knife Juggler to kill the Raid Leader, and that would remove the one buff on the Searing Totem. I think that's probably the best option right now. I can't rely on him making it past the next round anyway. I'm going to go ahead and sacrifice him. Kill the Raid Leader so he won't be able to throw out a ton of Murlocs or anything like that the next round. And he will have to throw away his attack on the mirror image. I'm fine with that. So we'll have to wait and see if sacrificing the Knife Juggler there was actually a good option or not. Again, I don't with shamans. If it were any other class than a shaman or a hunter, I usually wouldn't care. But having a minion out there that buffs the entire line of his minions is scary to me. And I do not want him to. I don't want to allow him to have that much that many minions on the board. So I do get him to burn the first hex there, and that's fine by me. And look at this. I do get a Sorcerer's Apprentice comes out, and that is very nice indeed. I do need to get more minions out there, and I think I'm going to go ahead and play both of my Taunters here. There's no reason for me to. I can't really do much of anything. He is going to have to waste the Searing Totem on either one of my tanks or waste that attack on the hex, and I am okay with that indeed. So right now I'm lacking a little bit of card draw. My opponent is still sitting at, looks like, 7 cards right now. And he's going to go with Doomhammer, and that has a lot of durability. Does 2 damage, and I believe it also has Wind Fury. Is that correct? Yep. So he's going to be able to swing basically 4 total times, which is technically 8 singular times. But I'm interested to see what he's planning on doing here, because if he wants to swing twice on the Shield Master, I'm willing to let him. Hopefully he's not that dumb. So he is going to go ahead and take out the Frostwolf, or the Ungrimmar Grunt, I believe is the name of that. And he's going to use that attack. I want to see if he's going to hit the Shield Master. I don't think he's going to. I'd be pretty foolish if he does. So I have to wait and see what his plan is. Again, I'd have no reason to burn Polymorph or anything
like
that.
Ready for action.
And there's the Golchar Footman.
There is little time.
And that is that. Arcane Intellect's a great draw here. Again, I don't really have much use of anything to throw out right now, so I'm going to go ahead and get a little bit of card draw back. There's a Cobalt Geomancer, and look at that. A Iron Beak Owl comes out, which will allow me to silence anything that I need to. I think right now the best option is to go ahead and get a little bit of spell power out there and see if I can get him to attack. I want to bait him into attacking the Shield Master with his... with his Doomhammer. So I'm going to go ahead and take out the Stone Claw Totem. I know I keep calling Stone Talon. Use my Hero Power to burn the Searing Totem, and that is that. Now, again, you may be asking yourself, why did I not attack the Footman? Is because I want to bait him into attacking my Shield Master twice. Because if he does attack it twice, he is not going to be able to kill it without buffing himself. And look at that. I get him to burn the second hex here on turn 7, and I am fine with that. That means that I don't have to worry about any more crowd control from him for the rest of the game. Unfortunately, he is able to kill my Geomancer, but hey, I traded a hex for it. I am fine with that. And he is quickly losing his durability on Doomhammer. I still feel okay right now. So I'm going to go ahead and get my Taunter back out there. And I'm going to go ahead and get my Sorcerer's Apprentice out as well. That way I can start having some endgame spell course of action is the phrase I'm looking for. Right now it's going to be a toss-up. I mean, I do have to worry about Doomhammer, but again, I'm fine with him just beating himself up against my tanks, because God knows I have plenty of them in there in my deck right now. I also have to stop. I got to stop fidgeting with the catapult. So look at that. He is going to burn Feral Spirit right off the bat here and throw out a Manatide Totem. And he is just going to go all the way out. There's Earth Shock. It's going to silence the Fen Creeper, and he's going to go ahead and kill the Apprentice. And that is that. So he burned a lot of cards there, and he's banking on having that Manatide Totem there for the rest of the game to provide him with his card draw, and I am, of course, not going to allow that to happen. I think everyone kind of knows what I'm going to do next, and it is a no-brainer option. We're going to go ahead and nuke the entire board, get rid of everything out there. There's no reason for me to put the Iron Beak Owl out right now. So I do clear the board. My Fen Creeper, even though he is silenced, he's still very beefy at 3-5, and he will do a lot of damage. It all adds up, my friends. It all adds up. So now my opponent, he invested quite heavily on turn 8 there, and he was not really wanting to see that. Here comes the Sunwalker, and Frost Shock is going to freeze the Fen Creeper. And I'm fine with that. And he's going to do 2 damage to himself. He's going to hit it again, actually. I don't know why he froze it. He just attacked it. I guess it was to deal that 1 damage, but... I think we all know what I'm going to do here. I'm just going to go ahead and polymorph the Divine Sunwalker, whatever the hell her name was, and I'm going to get out my Grizzly, and I'm going to get out my Tauren Warrior. That way I have my Enrage ready to go if I need to use it or if I can use it. But again, right now I feel like I'm forcing my opponent into a position where he's always on the defensive backhand, he's always on his back heel, rather. Backhand. I've been watching too much tennis lately. And he really hasn't had the ability to really get out of the gate with much of any damage. Other than Doomhammer, that's really the only thing he's had, and he's done a lot more damage to himself than I've actually done to him. So he gets a nice little draw there with the healing totem. And his card draw is quickly dwindling down. Even though I have no card draw, I do know that I have Arcane Intellect. I still have my Acolyte of Pain. I've still got my my Cultist as well. So he's going to go ahead and attack the... Okay, so yeah, so that was a good move. So he's going to attack the Torn Warrior to enable the Enrage and then sacrifice the Polymorph on that. Here comes Defender Argus. He's going to buff up the Healing Totem. And that's pretty neat indeed. However, I do have ways to deal with that. And what else will he throw out here? He's going to throw out Totemic Might, so he's going to give that Healing Totem a lot of health, 1-5. So that would be beefy indeed. Unfortunately for our friend over here, Aeth, I'm not going to let him get away with that. I'm going to go ahead and silence the Healing Totem. That will remove the taunt. That will remove pretty much everything on the board there. And I'm going to... I don't really want to sacrifice my bear if I don't have to, but again, I don't want to allow my opponent to be able to leave any minions on the board. So I think what the best thing to do is to make him believe that I still have something in my hand. I'm going to go ahead and trade the bear for the Defender of Argus. There's no reason in really attacking anything right here, but I'm going to attack Thrall just for the heck of it. And the reason why I say that is because the Healing Totem is not going to be able to heal anymore, but there's no point in attacking the Totem when I can just go straight for Thrall. So this is one of the longer Hearthstone contests here, and really what's going to come down to now is card draw. Who has put together the better deck? I don't know if I have or he has. It's 14 cards each in each player's decks. He's going to go ahead and use Totemic Call again. Gets a nice draw there on the Stoneclaw Totem. He's going to use Bloodlust, and that's a very early Bloodlust, and he's going to give the Healing Totem Wind Fury. So that is something. He's going to go ahead and use all of his Wind Fury charges on one unit, and that was that. I don't know if that was really worth it, but hey, I'm not going to ask questions, so I'm going to go ahead and just go all out at this point. He doesn't really have a whole lot in terms of removal that I can think of anyway. He could have Thunderstorm, but even Thunderstorm is not enough to kill everything on the board. That would only kill, even if he had a Wrath of Air Totem, that would only be able to kill the bear and the owl. I would still have a Taunter, but he does know that I have no more cards left. At this point, I'm all in. And Forked Lightning deals 2 damage to a random enemy. To 2 random enemies, unfortunately for him, he did not get the owl out of the out of the field. And a Stormwind Champion comes down as well. But unfortunately for our friend here, that is not enough to really do much. I do have, let's see, I'm going to go ahead and throw out the Ancient Mage. Spell Power, again, does not affect hero damage, unfortunately. However, let's see, he's got 8. I can do 6 damage to him, and I think that's the better option here because I don't feel like I need to be trading anything. I'm okay with letting him have the Stormwind Champion. And again, that's a risk I'm willing to take. To have him to go to 1 health, I have a guaranteed 1 damage in my hand. And the reason why I say that is because Jaina's hero power is the Fire Blast, and that does 1 damage. So let's see if he's going to get a Stoneclaw. Oh, he gets a very lucky Stoneclaw. Wow, that is super duper lucky. So he is going to go ahead and throw everything that he's got, taking out the Taunters, and will that be enough? We'll have to wait and see. All I have to do is basically kill the Stoneclaw Totem, and he's going to use Lightning Bolt, so that is enough. And he says, well played. I don't think it's quite over yet there, buddy. I'm not sure if it's over because I can't really attack him. Actually, I can attack him. So that isn't going to be that. I forgot that the hero powers go past Taunters, so that's going to be that. Good games overall. Not too confident in my maging abilities because I just don't like the class, but you saw it from start to finish. I constructed the deck, gave you my logic, and then put it to action. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. I hope you're having a great day. And, of course, I will see you all next time. So long, everybody.